Hello everybody, this is Alexander. I'm the author of Docker-OpenVPN project. Basically, this project allows you to create your own Dockerized OpenVPN server in less than a few seconds. It is a very amazing possibility, taking into account that basically users spend from 1 day to 3 days in order to install all the dependencies they need in order to operate their VPN server. In this project, everything is all the dependencies are packed into a single Docker container, which you can run on any physical server, on any virtual private server, basically on any unit which is capable of running Docker. Docker is the only requirement you need to have on your machine. You will also have to have a public IP address assigned to your server. I have already mentioned that you will have to have a server capable of running Docker. There are many internet service providers willing to provide you this possibility to run Docker containers to provide out-of-the-box solutions, Linux installations which already have Docker on board. But for this tutorial, we will use DigitalOcean service. I find it very good and convenient and reasonably priced. First of all, let's create our new server. Servers in terms of DigitalOcean are called droplets. So let's create one. Here we can choose an image we want to use for our droplet. If we want to have Docker already pre-installed, we need to go to Marketplace tab and find Docker. Yeah, we are going to use this image. Let's click on it. I already clicked on it. Second thing, the default server configuration is 8 gigabytes of RAM, 4 CPUs, 160 gigabytes of SSD disk, which is definitely an overkill for needs. So I suggest we scroll to the left, and here we can see configuration of 1 gigabyte of operative memory, 25 gigabytes of SSD disk, and it costs only $5 a month, which will totally suffice our needs unless we're going to use thousands of simultaneous connections, which is something Docker OpenVPN project was not designed for. So let's click on it. Let's choose our data center region. I suggest we stick to the closest geolocation of your physical location, which in my case is Frankfurt. There are a couple of other options. What is in our keen interest is SSH keys. My public SSH key I imported before is already pre-selected, and I'm gonna leave it as is. So I believe we're done with our settings, and now let's hit this green button create. So our droplet is being created. It's basically, it's not gonna take long. usually it takes 1 to 2 minutes to create a totally new droplet, but sometimes it might take a little bit longer, or sometimes it is created almost instantaneously. It depends, but we don't have many options to do here. We just need to patiently wait till our server created, and once it is created we can proceed to the next step. Yes, voila, it was created. We see that public IP address was assigned to it. There is this, when we hover this IP address, blue button to the right of it appears. Let's click on it. So our IP address was copied into our clipboard, and now we will have to go to terminal window in order to connect to our newly created server via SSH. So let's do that. Oops, please don't pay much attention to this. These are some leftovers from my previous work. So yeah, SSH, we are going to connect as a root user. And now let's paste our IP address. The application, the SSH asks us if we are going to trust our newly created server. Of course we are going to trust it, in case we know, then there is no sense to continue this tutorial, so we're definitely going to type in yes. Yes, we were successfully connected to our newly created server. It should already have Docker installed, and I'm just gonna check it out. Yeah, it says that the Docker installed, and these are the commands. So the next thing we are going to do is we are going to follow this manual, and there are basically two options for setting up your Docker OpenVPN server. The first option suggests that you specify your server's public IP address manually. And sometimes it is justified, but in most cases you just can use this automated option which employs IPFI service, which discovers your server's public IP address and return it. So we're going to use this second option. Let's copy this line and now we're going to paste it into terminal window, and let's see what is about to happen. So yeah, our OpenVPN server service has successfully started. Here we can see its output. It says that a client OVPN file has been generated, config server started, and the next thing we need to do, we need to go to this address. We need to select it. We need to go to our browser window. Here we're going to create new tab, and we are going to paste this address into the address bar. Yeah, new configuration, client configuration has been created. Let's click on it. On this computer, I'm using TunnelBleak as OpenVPN client. It asks if we are going to install this newly downloaded configuration for all users or only for me. For the sake of this tutorial, I'm going to click the default option, which is only me. And here I need to type my admin password for this machine. Yeah, this sound signifies that a new configuration has successfully been installed, and we now should be able to see this in the list of available configurations. Yeah, we can see it. And the next thing I'm going to do is to click on this connect client. I'm clicking on it, and we can see in the status in the TunnelBleak status window that the connection has been successfully established, and now we can check our IP address. So previously my IP address was the following. I'm physically located in Riga, Latvia, and as we connected to our newly created Docker OpenVPN server, now our IP address should be something different. Our location should be in Frankfurt, Germany. Yes, as you can see, it works well, and we are browsing the internet from different location, and the internet thinks we are in Germany, and this is very exciting opportunity if you need to circumvent censorship, avoid some GeoIP blocking and so on and so forth. So please use this service for whatever reason you need, and bye bye for now.